to see me nervous, so be excited and make me a little less nervous, alright? Okay, so come in your writing your exams. Exam you're writing now, it's going on. Lift your hand. Okay, very good. Let's clap for them this time. Come in for I get to write your exam. Get to write, okay, let's clap for them too.
Very, very familiar to us, okay? Ever since we were born, ever since
were told to do this. When we came to church, when we came to Sunday class, we were told to do this. And what is it? Why, as teens, as youngsters, we have million reasons, very many reasons. Aunties will have some reason. Everyone has different reasons for loving God. But as teens, as youngsters, we have to talk about these reasons for loving God. Okay? So why love God? Can someone tell why you love God? One person. I wanted to write names. And I wanted to pick names to ask questions, but I forgot to do that. So please answer. One person. Why love God? Why do you love God? Everyone said yes when you said you love God. But give me a reason. Because He loves us.
Because He loves us.
Yes. Very good. Let's clap. Okay. Because He loves us. Okay. So the Bible says that whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love. Say to me, God is love. Once again,
God is love.
Okay, so if we don't love, it is because we don't know God. But if we want to love, we have to know God, right? So that's why we're going to talk about why we need to love God. And I'm going to give you, we're going to talk about three reasons why, as teens, we have to love God. Okay. So, as teens, as youngsters, okay, till a certain point in our lives, we're going to go through constant changes. What?
Constant
changes. Changes from school to college to university, from university to work, and work, we may go to one work and many, many work, and finally we settle in one place and we settle our lives, okay? But till then, we're going to have constant changes, okay? And now, as teens, our bodies are also changing. Yes? We're growing. Very fast we're growing, right? Can you see it yourselves? Can you see yourself changing? Yes? So we are constantly changing. Yes? So how many of y'all are in school? Y'all in school. Okay, good. So y'all have best friends?
No.
No? Y'all have best friends? Y'all have friends? Friends? Yes. Okay, y'all are best friends, right? When I was in school, I used to have 4 best friends, okay? So they were there with me when I was down. They used to wipe my tears. Okay, when I fought, they were there with me. We shared our lunch. We ate the same food. And they knew who I liked. They knew who I didn't like. They knew when I cried at home. They knew when my dad scolded me. They knew every single thing about me, okay? So those 4 people became my best friends. But what happened when I moved to college? They all went in different directions, right? So they are still my friends. I'm not saying no, but they can't be with me. They can't do every single day with me, right? So what happened when I came to college? I got new friends. So they became my everything. I shared lunch with them. They were there with me to wipe my tears, to see me happy, to fight when I fought, when I cried, everything. They were there with me. And what happened? I moved to degree college. And then I couldn't take them with me. They are still my best friends, but I couldn't take them with me. I found new friends. And the same thing happened. They are there with me now. I eat with them. I play with them. I laugh with them. Everything with them. But what happened? Changes, right? What happened?
Changes.
So the same people that wiped my tears in school are not there with me anymore. The same people that stood with me in college are not there with me anymore. So what happens?
Changes.
Right? The same people can't go with you everywhere. So y'all are going from school to college, from college to university, from university to wherever you're going. The people that are with you are still going to be there for you, but they're not going to be your constants. They're going to change. What? They can't be your
constants.
Right. Okay. So how many of y'all remember what happened when you were
God in your mother's womb.
You all remember?
No, none of us can remember.
Okay, what happened when we were in PKG?
LKG, UKG.
Remember what happened?
Everything that happened?
No, you can't remember.
What happened when we were in first standard or second standard or third standard?
You remember?
Picture by everything?
No.
No, you can't.
Absolutely no.
Okay, so now, do you know how old are you all?
Okay.
How old are you all?
Age kuda yamba.
Okay. So, do you all know what will happen in the next 12 years?
No.
Do you all know what will happen in the next year?
No.
Do you all know what will happen tomorrow?
No.
But there is one person that knows it all. Before you were found in your mother's womb, when you were in your mother's womb, when you were in first, second, third, fourth, fifth, wherever you are now, and to the coming years, okay? He can see whatever can happen, whatever will happen. So who is our constant?
Jesus.
Right? Let's clap for him. Yes, he is our constant. So God is your constant. That is the number one reason why we have to hold on to him. As teens, as youngsters, change is constant. We can see people changing. Everything is changing around us so fast. The trend that was there yesterday is no more a trend today. The fashion that was there yesterday is no more a fashion today. The artist that we loved yesterday is no more our favorite today. So it is changing, okay? So who is our constant? God alone can be our constant. We have to hold on to that. Otherwise, we count on people to be our constant and we get disappointed. Right? Yes or no?
Yes.
So I want to urge you today. I'm sure you all know this, you all knew this, that you need to love God. But you need to love God because God is your constant. Alright? Okay, let's move to the next one. God is your lover. How sweet does that sound? We all need a lover, yes?
Yes.
Or no? We all need it, okay? Don't deny it. We all need it. Okay, so we look for love in so many places, in so many people, in so many things we look for love. But I can tell you that I can tell you from the bottom of my heart that there is no lover like our God. He makes me so emotional sometimes, but I'm telling you this is the truth. And what does the Bible say? Ephesians 3:20 says, God can do anything, you know, far more than you could ever imagine or guess or request in your wildest dreams. What is it, the last two words? Wildest dreams. We spoke about dreams, right? But God can do more than we can imagine even in our wildest dreams. We wouldn't have dreams. Our fantasy, right? We can imagine anything and everything. But God can do more than that. More than we can imagine, God can do. You believe it?
Yes.
Okay, I'm going to give you examples, okay? Three examples. My mom's here, she wouldn't know. But, yeah. So, I had my birthday, okay? In November, I had my birthday. It was a Sunday. We all came to church. I had a very good day, okay? But for birthday, I didn't do anything, okay? I had wishes from church, had little kids thank me, asking God to bless me. It was all lovely, lovely, okay? But I went home, we had lunch, but I didn't do anything for my birthday, for me. It was a special Sunday, but it wasn't a birthday. I think deep down in my heart, I had a wish saying, at least my birthday cake would have made it my birthday, okay? I think down in my heart. And I forgot about it, okay? I really forgot about it. I think 2 weeks passed by, Rekha aunty knows. I think 2 weeks passed by and I go to this place, our castle with Rekha aunty, and I was really down that day. I don't know why, I forgot why, but I was really down, okay? I was very, no interest, somewhat, okay? And then we had a surprise, Rekha aunty and I. After 20 days of my birthday, when I was down, they gave me a surprise. We cut cake. Rekha aunty and I cut cake. Isn't that amazing? And who did that? God did that. The desire that I forgot by myself, God remembered. And look at the beauty of it. His timing. What's the beauty of it? chose to give me a birthday cake. Isn't that beautiful? I totally forgot my desire, my wish. I forgot about it, but God remembered, right? If God cares for our little desires like this, then He will forget how much more our big dreams, our big desires, our big wishes, right? We won't see Him working every day because those are long-term. But through these little desires that God fulfills, God reminds us that He is working on our big desires, on our big visions, on our big goals. Let's clap our hands for Him. One more example I want to give. It's not about me. There's someone I know. He's older. Okay, I think he's around 30. And he's working, okay? So one day, I get messages from him saying he's really down, he's depressed, he's crying, and he doesn't know why. And he's feeling a little lost, a little not interested. And I was saying, okay, I'm not brave, you know, God is there for you. What more can you do? I'm being a human, I could say only that. But God, what did God do? The next day, I get a message from him saying he got a promotion. What did he get? He got a promotion and he never expected the promotion. He never expected. And what is the beauty of it is not that he got a promotion, but the time that God chose to give him the promotion, when he was down, when he was not interested, when he was lost, when he was depressed, when he was crying, that's when God chose to give him the promotion. If he got the promotion any other day, he would have definitely told, thank you God, it is because of you. But because God gave him during that time, he could say, God, what a lover you are. Look at your surprises. Look at the way you make me happy. Look at the way you cheer me up. Isn't it amazing? Let's clap our hands for our God. So He is our lover. Okay? So the third reason why we need to hold on to God is because we need a cheerleader. How many of you all need a cheerleader? You know what a cheerleader is? Yes? Y'all know what a cheerleader is? Come on, we all watch football, cricket, and everyone's clapping. Whether the team is doing good, whether the team is doing bad, whether the team is winning, whether the team is losing, there is someone that's there for the team cheering them up, saying, go, you can do it. Come on, you can do it, right? We all need that someone. God has blessed us with so many people that cheer us on. But our God is our only cheerleader who is our constant, right? I'm going to give you how does God cheer us up, okay? So God says, you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. Okay, He's our constant, He's our lover, and He says that. Okay, and what does He say? When I'm with you, when I'm in you, who can be against you, right? What else does He say? The joy of the Lord is my strength. Right? My mom keeps reminding me, every time I'm down, she keeps reminding me that be happy, be joyful in the joy of the Lord. That's like a reminder that she gives to me, but that is so true. Every day, God is there for us, no matter how bad our day is, how good our day is. And one thing that we can celebrate every day is that God's presence is always there, supporting us, pushing us, right? So next time, if you are playing a game, maybe cricket or football, or maybe you're writing an exam, or maybe you're giving a speech in your classroom, whatever you're doing, know that God's voice is cheering you, okay? These are the three reasons why you need to love God, okay? Can you repeat it? What's the first one? God's our constant. Second, God's our lover. Third, God's our cheerleader. Isn't that amazing? Let's clap our hands for God. God wants to be our constant. God wants to be our lover. God wants to be our cheerleader. But we need to make a choice to make Him our constant, to make Him our lover, to make Him our cheerleader. So how do we do that every single day? Throw the word. How do we do that every single day? Okay, I'm going to give you four things. Quickly, let's do it. Okay. So the Bible says to reach out and experience the breath, test its length, plumb the depths, rise to the heights. You all know the song we sing? Love of Jesus, sweet and marvelous, love of Jesus, sweet and marvelous. And then what does it say? So high, can't get over it, so come on, sing. So high, can't get around it, oh, marvelous love. Okay, so without testing, days. My mom talks a lot in the kitchen. I can hear her, and if she's talking, I will definitely know she's talking to God. Okay, so we all have our own ways of talking to God. And sometimes what we do is, talking to God becomes in the end, okay? When we're going to sleep, kneel down, pray, thank God for what it's right. We need to do that. But how else do we talk to God? I'll tell you how I talk to God. My mom doesn't know again. So my house is like my comfort zone, okay? I can wear anything, be anything, talk anything, do anything in my house. Nobody cares. I'm still loved, okay? But when I step out of my house, I feel like I'm facing the world, okay? So every day I get up, I get dressed, and when I leave, when I step out of the gate, I feel like I'm going into the world, you know? So I have something in me. So you know what I do immediately? I take my earphones, I connect my earphones to my phone. Sometimes I play music, but otherwise I connect my earphones and I start talking. And I start talking to whom? To God, okay? So I want to make Him early in my morning. I want to make Him my constant. I want to make Him my lover. I want to make Him my cheerleader. So I walk to the bus stop, and as I walk, I will keep talking. And why do I put my earphones? So that people think I'm not mad, okay? If I don't use my earphones, definitely they think I'm mad. So I put my earphones and I talk. Sometimes I love this picture because that's how I blush sometimes. Like the whole thing, that's how I blush. I blush when I'm talking. Do all that, okay? God is your lover. Talk to Him like a friend, like a lover, okay? So early in the morning, I do that. So that's my way of talking to God. And when I come back to college, when I come back after college, it's like I'm done with my day and I'm going home. So I thank God for the day and everything. So talk to God. Change the slide before telling you. Okay. So talk to God, okay? However you like to talk to God, it's amazing. Compliment God. When you see something, if you see yourself, if you find yourself looking good, say, God, wow, you made me so good, okay? If you see a tree that's beautiful, say, God, wow, the tree is so beautiful. Make Him a part of every single thing that you do. And it doesn't have to be praying. It has to be talking to Him so that you make Him your constant. Okay. So how many of y'all think crying is bad? It's not bad, right? But so many times they say to boys, don't cry like
girls.
Girls, okay. Don't cry like girls. Come on, crying. They say crying is very good. Psychologists say, researchers say, counselors say that you need to cry. But, okay, let them say anything. Counselors say that you need to cry. But they don't tell us who to cry to, right? So we all know. As children of God, we're so lucky, we're so privileged that we all know who to cry to. And I'll tell you why. People say don't waste your tears, right? They say that. But crying to Him, I'm sure that not even a single drop of your tear goes wasted. Okay? Sometimes, if you cry to people, you know, sometimes when I cry, if my friends are around, I would just make sure that I don't even look funny, okay? That's not the case with God. You can cry however, you can look however, you can be however, wherever. Most of the time I cry in the room to God, okay? So you can cry anywhere, but God still sees all your tears. And trust me, it's true. Okay? So first thing, what do you do? Talk to Him. Second, I cry to Him. Next time somebody says crying is not good, say, I cry to my God, I cry to my King, I cry to my lover. Isn't that amazing? God sees our tears. Okay. What's the next one? Worship. How do you worship Him every day? Go worship Him every day? Yes? There are a million songs that we know, that we've learned growing up. You can sing it anytime. It's not about singing, but what is worship? Worship is expressing your love, expressing your gratitude. That's it. Everyone can do it. Some people think only the, you know, people who are so pure, some people think only the ones who are so perfect should do it. But no, anyone, we all can express our love. We all can, we all should express our love, should express our gratitude through worship. Some of you are listening to movie songs. Y'all listen to movie songs? Yes? Yes? Okay, we some way or the other we come across Moni song. Whether we want to intentionally listen or unintentionally listen, we all come across Moni song. I came across one song, okay? It's a Tamil song. Yeah, one song. Okay, it says, Yenoda Ni Inda, you know? You know? What's the next line? Uyiroda Naan Irupen. What does it say? Yenoda Ni Inda, Uyiroda Naan Irupen. If you are with me, I'm going to live. Who's it sing? Who's singing it? Some guy is singing it. Who's he singing it to? Some girl. Okay, maybe that girl is giving him life. Okay, let's keep it. Maybe he's giving him life. Maybe he's living only because of her. But who is giving her life? Who is giving her life? Okay, maybe someone else is giving her also life. Who is giving that someone else also life? God is the ultimate source of life. Yes? Thank you, thank you, God. So because he is giving. If a guy can sing so much, with so much feeling, with so much dedication, with so much talent, everything, to some girl who's not even giving him life, how much more should we sing to God who gives us life and breath every single minute? He is the reason, right? How much more? Think about it. We listen to so many songs and we are here as children of God. He's been blessed us with so many things. You know, it's not only about singing. It's any talent that God has given, if you use it for His glory, it is again worshipping Him. Yes? You believe it?
Yes.
Okay. So let's make these three habits. What is it?
Thank you.
Okay. Fourth thing. Okay. That's the last thing. What is it? Appetite for God. What is it? What do you mean by appetite? Huh? You can see the picture, right? The man's trying to gobble up so much of food, right? What's that? He has a big appetite. He has an appetite for so much food, he thinks. But all those kind of appetites sometimes harm us. Most of the time harm us. But this one appetite will never, ever, 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 ever harm us. Yes? Okay, so we need to have an appetite, a big appetite for God. Everyone say it?
Big appetite.
Big appetite for God.
Big appetite.
I don't know from where I got it, but I have an unusually big appetite for God. I don't know how, but sometimes what I do is download YouTube videos and I put it on my phone. And if I have 3 hours, I listen to sermons. I listen in college or if I have 3 hours. So I have this unusually like big appetite for God and I'm really grateful because it is helping me in so many ways. Okay? So I'll tell you why you need to have an appetite for God at this age. Okay? So we all have many temptations, right? We all need to stay away from certain things. We all need to go ahead and do certain things. So before we do or before we stay away or before we do certain things, how does this appetite for God help us? We learn what we need to do. We learn what we need not do. Okay, and God talks to us. God says, I will instruct you, I will counsel you, I will teach you, I will guide you. So for all those reasons, we need to have an appetite for God. Now I'll give you one example. Okay? So last month in college we had fest. You all like fest in college? Yes, everyone loves fest in college, okay? Every girl dresses up colorful, people from outside come, they have food stalls, they have games, they have competitions, they have what not, okay? So I was there on the first day of my fest, but I was there just because I was part of college, okay? I wanted to see what was happening, I wanted to see what kind of fun people have. So I stayed back, and I saw all that was happening, and I don't know, it gave me a strange feeling, okay? I felt so lost. I felt so, you know, I didn't know where I belong. I didn't know what to enjoy. I didn't know what kind of fun was for me, okay? I was very, very broken. So, the second day of the fest, what happened? I had to go to college. And as I was packing my bag, my mom doesn't know again. Okay, as I was packing my bag, I don't know what made, I didn't plan on it, okay? I really didn't plan on it, trust me. I took out all my books from from my bag, and something made me take my Bible, put it in, I took water bottle, and I left the college. I don't know what I was going to do with the Bible. I don't know, but I was going to college. I went to college, and I went to a quiet place. The test was going on. I didn't go there. I went to a quiet place, okay? And trust me, I opened the Bible. It wasn't a scripture that I randomly opened. It was something that I had to read that day. I read, okay? Mostly every day I read. So that day I was supposed to read that passage, okay? I opened it and I couldn't believe it. God said, it said, He is your life. Isn't that amazing? I felt tears rolling down, and I'm still like, it's still overwhelming. I read it and it's so perfect, and I got some kind of confidence, some kind of strength, and that passage was so beautiful. It explains how life with Christ is. I felt that fun may be good for them, but this is a greater kind of life. Yes or no? They don't have such freedom. We have freedom of love. We have freedom from sin. We have freedom from shame, from guilt, from whatnot. We have such freedom. And that fun may be fun for them, but we have a bigger, we have a more lovely, we have a much more beautiful life compared to them. So, which is why you need to have a big appetite for God. If I did not have, I wouldn't have read the Bible that way, and God wouldn't have spoken to me, and I would have still been lost, still with questions, still with worries, still with confusion. But what happened? Because of the appetite for God, God spoke. Right? Okay? So what is it? First,
talk to him.
To God. Second,
cry to him.
Cry to God. Third,
worship him.
Worship God. Fourth, big appetite. I missed it, okay? A big appetite for God. Okay? I'm done.